On the News Hour tonight, joining me from Chennai is another honest and efficient IAS officer who in his 23 years of civil service, I think has been posted some 18 times. His name is C. Uma Shankar. He's got many awards. He was named Man of the Next Millennium by The Week magazine for his groundbreaking work. As an honest IAS officer, it's my pleasure to introduce you on the News Hour this evening. Thank you very much, C. Uma Shankar. Khushbu is a leader of the DMK joining us from Chennai. Bukkal Nawab still is adamant that he is right and the whole world is wrong on this. I don't know what line of defense the Samajwadi Party has left in this case. Nirmala Sitharaman, national spokesperson of the BJP, is with me in the studios this evening. My first question is to Qasim Ali Khan, Congress leader. Now, it must be terrible. It must be terrible, Mr. Qasim Ali Khan, that in order to protect your political interest, you have to trample upon your conscience, which is exactly what the Congress party is doing by maintaining a mute silence on the persecution of the
IAS officer. I don't think so. That's true, Arnav, because I'm quite open about what I think about this entire situation. I think the IAS officer is being victimized totally.
And your party is a party to it.
Whatever. I don't think it's
a... No, what do you mean, whatever?
It's not a party to it.
Of course it's a party.
No, not at all. This is done by the Samajwadi government. They are a majority government. The government just... this is not the isolated case. I don't think this is an isolated case. In Rampur itself, three DMs were moved out within a span of 1 year just because they didn't act on the behest of the local minister. And now the DM, he's a PCS officer who's a promotee and he's working under pressure. So this is something which is happening in Rampur all the time.
Yeah, but the support for your government for the parliament session is so important here that you've had to swallow your pride, sell...
I'm quite vocal about my views.
What about the views of your party? What got their tongue? Why have they all gone
quiet?
Well,
I think you should ask the spokesman those questions. I can speak for myself.
Well, you can speak for yourself, but I don't know. But Nirmala Sitharaman, the Congress party's defenses, we'll speak for ourselves. We're not responsible for what's happening in Uttar Pradesh on this.
Well, I can see their point because they have to keep the Samajwadi party happy. But the law and order situation in Uttar Pradesh is so bad today that any honest official trying to do any sincere work is definitely at odds with the government's agenda. And this is a classic example where an official whose superior has himself given a report saying she was not in the wrong.
Yep.
And here is an adamant chief minister who is insisting on taking the action which he thinks fit, but not as per law.
Yep.
So therefore here I would think Congress, which normally is very enthusiastic about protecting the bureaucrats, rightly so, where they deserve to be. Why is it unnecessarily dragging its feet in this matter? They should speak up. And they should very clearly tell...
They can't afford to speak up. They can't afford...
You said very clearly that you're speaking...
No,
just a minute.
I'm a Congress MLA.
Wait a minute.
I mean, I'm a sitting Congress MLA. I'm speaking up.
I'm not sure.
What is right is right. What is wrong is wrong.
Where's the rest of your party?
But you also very clearly said...
You should have contacted the rest of my party.
No, but you also very clearly said that you are speaking for yourself and not for the party.
Your party's position is very clear.
See, Nirmala ji, you are the national spokesperson of a political party.
No, one sec, Qasim.
I'm not the national spokesperson.
But your party is a regional...
But here is the situation. Here is the situation.
I'm a Congress MLA, but
it does not hurt you.
Right. She is right.
It does not...
And she is right. That's a fact.
It does not hurt you that your ally is even willing to create communal disturbances where there is none. One second.
Yeah.
You are willing to create communal disturbances where there is none. And you want to let the Mulayam Singh Yadav government get away with it. That's the price that you're willing to pay to hang on to the coattails of the Samajwadi party in order to pass your bills in parliament next week. I think that's criminal, Qasim Ali. But let me get Khushbu in on this. Khushbu, what do you think? Shazia is also joining us on the debate from the Aam Aadmi Party. Khushbu, what do you think of what's going on in Uttar Pradesh in the Durga Shakti case?
I think when you look at Durga Shakti case, when she's got a clean sheet from the higher officials and a high command, I think it shows very clearly that she's been completely victimized for taking on the mafia of the sand in Madhya Pradesh. And when you look at it, I think the way things have been happening there in that state, it's really saddening that law and order, you don't even know if law and order actually exist, because every time I have been on your show, Arnav, we have always discussed Akhilesh Yadav and his governance. And I think every time we discuss, we always try to point out that how law and order is going from bad to worse in that state. And I think it's high time people really stand up and say that we have chosen you and we need a better government and we need better people to rule us. I think it's really high time we, people of that state,
yeah, start. But with your parties, your party is also an expert in hounding bureaucrats, isn't it? Your party is also an expert in hounding bureaucrats. I'm sorry to have to make this point about every political party in the country,
no,
because they're
no,
all experts
no, I
at hounding
I won't
honest
say that
bureaucrats.
You know,
you have suspended no, bureaucrats. Let me speak. You have suspended bureaucrats for daring to take on political dynasties as vigilance commissioners. You want me to give the list of what your party has done, where the suspension has been revoked? These
yes,
officers have alleged harassment.
Please give the list.
They've been harassed
please
across
give
the
list,
board.
Arnab.
Pardon me.
Please give the list, Arnab. I'm waiting for the
well,
list
I can
to come
give the list
you,
of people
please
who have been transferred 18 times in their 20-year career.
Please.
Well,
no,
you want examples?
I'm waiting
I can
for
give
you to
the
give
examples.
The list, Arnab. Please
of
give
course,
me the example,
I'll give you the examples. The first example I'd like to give you is a former district collector of Madurai, Mr. Sagayam, an IS officer who said he had never been offered a bribe because he made his stand clear from the day he joined the services. He was shunted around frequently. He was transferred 18 times in his 20-year career. You want more examples?
No, 20 years.
You want more examples?
20 years it was not DMK who ruled. Wait, it was not 20 years at a stretch what DMK ruled when he was the IS officer. As far
yeah,
as
so
even
you
when
shared,
I was going
you shared,
through, you were talking about...
You shared persecuting this officer. That's what you did. Let me get Uma Shankar.
No, I said no, you give me the... I
you
said,
know,
you,
you know,
me,
I'll say...
You just
no,
gave
no.
me a list. You said a list. You have just named one, Arnav.
Yeah, so?
So,
so what do you want me to give you others as well?
DMK wasn't leading for the last 20 years. It's been always DMK, AIDMK, DMK, AIDMK.
Yeah.
That is all it has been going on.
Oh, come on.
And as
know.
Far as Sagayan was concerned, I think we have seen what has happened.
I'll ask Uma Shankar.
We have seen
I'll ask Uma Shankar. No, I'll ask Uma Shankar, who's a senior bureaucrat. I think he's a 1990 batch IAS officer. Because I want to really expose this whole
yes.
thing tonight about how politicians come together to take on bureaucrats and then say, when there are acts of corruption, they say, oh, that it's the bureaucrats who want to be corrupt. It's politicians who make the bureaucrats corrupt and then they coexist with corrupt bureaucrats. And those bureaucrats who are honest are shunted out of your system. That's the problem in our country. Uma Shankar, Khushbu says this doesn't happen in the DMK time. Why don't you give her a clearer idea of whether or not it happens in the DMK time?
Arnab, whether it is DMK or AIDMK or any other government for that matter in India, it happens all the time. I have the experience
yes.
of getting transfer orders within 24 hours. That was under the AIDMK regime. And DMK
yes.
surpassed it by giving me transfer orders even when I was carrying out inspection. There was a company, 700 crore worth company, which has gone out of records. I was managing director of Elcott. This company has gone out of Elcott's control mysteriously. So as chairman of that company and as managing director of this government's company, I went looking for the company and I was sitting in the chairman's chamber asking for the records how the company mysteriously disappeared. It has got 700 crore asset. It is an SEZ in Chennai city. But then even when I was there trying to secure the documents, I was transferred from there during July 2008. That was during DMK's regime. So it
Look
is not DMK or
Look
AIDMK. It has happened under both the governments in the same fashion.
That's the point.
Yeah, Arnab.
That's exactly the point I'm making. See, Khushbu, that's exactly the point I'm making, that
yeah,
you're all together.
Saying.
You see,
it's
all political parties
saying,
are together.
Arnab,
in coming together,
I've
defending their interests, taking on honest bureaucrats.
No,
you want
Arnab.
To make an example of bureaucrats like him? No, why don't you tell your party chief Karunanidhi to go and give Uma Shankar a medal tomorrow? No, before you ask for a medal, which I'm sure you will for Durga Shakti, why don't you ask your party chief Karunanidhi to give Uma Shankar a medal?
Wait, Arnab, if you have asked a question, can I answer you?
Yeah, please, I'm waiting.
Yes, when you said you will give me a list, you could name one.
Yes.
I have been through the entire process of the history of Mr. Umashankar, and I completely agree with him when he said 2008 he was transferred. He was transferred, he was given in a transfer orders yeah. within a span of 24 hours when AIDMK was ruling. I'm not saying it doesn't happen in DMK. I'm not saying it has never happened in DMK. It does happen.
Ah, there you are. So you admit that you do it.
No.
That's the first time a politician has admitted on the news that honest bureaucrats are persecuted, hounded and transferred. I am very happy this admission has happened on the news tonight.
Arnab, I'm sorry, you sound very confused today. Don't sound confused. It's simple. It's not that always it's about hounding or getting protected and transferring the bureaucrats. It's not always like that. What has happened to Durga Shakti
so is what do you
very
call
clear.
It? What do you
she
call it, Khushbu? What do you call it, Khushbu? What is it
I'm
in
sure
your
Mr.
language?
Mr. Umashankar will be able to give a better explanation as to why the transfer orders were given and what the reasons were given. And I'm sure the investigations were also done when he was transferred during the DMK regime as to why he was transferred and the reasons were also would have been given. So let's not get confused
you
and
see,
say that 1 plus 1 is not
the,
2 but 11.
I don't know what you call
Please,
it. I don't know what you call it. I don't know what you call it. But I'll tell you one thing. Nobody, go on Mr. Umashankar. I don't think anybody joins the IAS to be hounded by politicians. Yes, Umashankar, you want to respond
not,
to her. Go ahead.
Yes,
and then
I'm
we
not,
come back
I'm
to
not,
the Durga
not
Shakti
not saying
case. We've got more participants joining it.
I'm not saying they do not. They are not hounded. They are. But
what do you call it? I call it hounded. What do you call it in your vocabulary? I call it persecution. What do you call it?
Mr. Arnab.
Appreciation.
Yeah, this was not the first transfer. In 2009, they called me back and made me Government Cable TV Corporation Managing Director. There, in Jan 2009, I sent proposal to nationalize Mr. Maran's company, Sumangali Cable Vision. And I was transferred to a non-significant, non-cadre post. I was suspended. They filed two false cases against me, vigilance cases against me. I have not been given increment for the past 3 years. I have not been promoted. I have not been empaneled as joint secretary to government. And the suspension order, they revoked after 43 days without any application from me because of public protest. And the present government also has not done anything. It is all there pending.
No, I only, you see, Mr. Umashankar, you know, why have I been looking at this case in great detail? Because I believe you ask anyone on the streets, are honest bureaucrats hounded? Of course they are. And you will not have any honest bureaucrats left in this country at this rate. Well, we have two Samajwadi leaders at our studios in Lucknow, Bukkal Nawabji. I Papa Sade program mein Dhanyavad Ravidas Mehrotra is also an MLA. So we have two leaders of the Samajwadi party. मेरा सवाल ये है रविदास मेहरोत्रा जी और बुक्कल नवाब जी आप दोनों से और मैं हिंदी और अंग्रेजी में दोनों में कहूंगा ताकि हमारे दोनों जो दर्शक हैं जो हिंदी और अंग्रेजी समझते हैं वो समझ सके अभी ऐसा हुआ है कि पिछले 24 घंटों में आपकी पार्टी आपके लीडर आपके मुख्यमंत्री एक्सपोज हो चुके हैं आपके सीनियर लीडर एक्सपोज हो चुके हैं सब कुछ निकल चुका है कि किस तरह से ये साजिश थी दुर्गा शक्ति जी के खिलाफ एविडेंस आ चुका है सामने टेप्स निकल आए हैं कि आपके लीडर्स ने क्या क्या कहा इसके बावजूद आप इतने एडमेंट क्यों हैं एडमेंट का मतलब हिंदी रूपांतर तो मैं आप इतने जिद्दी क्यों हैं आप इतने जिद्दी क्यों बन रहे हैं इस केस में आपसे गलती हो गई आपने कोशिश की कि इस आईएएस ऑफिसर को परेशान करें उनको डराएं आप एक्सपोज हो गए एक्सपोज होने के बाद आप ये जिद क्या दिखा रहे हैं देश के सामने
देखिए कोई गलती नहीं हुई है ब्यूरोक्रेट्स जो है वो डेमोक्रेसी के ऊपर हावी होने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं एक दुर्गा नागपाल ने मस्जिद की दीवार गिरा दी वहां तनाव पैदा हो गया सरकार ने सांप्रदायिक सद्भाव कायम रखने के लिए उस पर कार्रवाई करने का काम किया अगर वो कार्रवाई नहीं होती तो उस
झूठ
के अंदर वहां
झूठ है
तो सांप्रदायिक सब नहीं कैसे झूठ है एक अधिकारी
आप सांप्रदायिक आप हर चीज को
सबसे ज्यादा सबसे ज्यादा आपके मंत्री आजम खान ने रामपुर में सांप्रदायिकता फैलाई है अभी हाल ही में 10 दिन पहले एक मदरसे को तोड़ा गया एक मस्जिद के अंदर जबरदस्ती पुलिस घुसी
जो ये चाहते
सांप्रदायिकता उसे कहते हैं